Hey everybody, it's No Matter, and because it's the end of April, it's time for another monthly update, so let's get into it. So I'm just gonna say, you saw the title to this video, last month the EPs popped off, this month the albums popped off. First album that I've been listening to a lot is Tori by Tori Kelly. Tori Kelly isn't particularly an artist that I've listened to a lot or had a long history of listening to, but I decided to check out this new EP. I know that she'd done a lot of work with artists that I liked, such as Lecrae and Jacob Collier. She might have done something with Toby Mac, I don't remember, but Tori Kelly's always just killed it in those songs, so figured I'd see what was going on with this new self-titled album, and I was blown away. This is just something else. Only track that I personally skip is Alive If I Die, just because, you know, Tori Kelly's married, so sometimes her songs get into a little bit of a married territory, you know, so not something that I'm particularly interested in imposing on, but hey, rest of the album, knock yourself out. Believe it's all for me, make my dream come true, that thing you do, da, da, da. You could get that yesterday, you could get that soon as yesterday. You don't want to cut it, it's now on me. You want then you can do it. What do we call it? Smooth. What do we call it? What do we call it? Next album I want to talk about is Mr. Bill's new album, Mechanomorphic. I've never particularly delved into Mr. Bill's discography either, actually, even though everything that I've heard from him, mostly, actually, all collabs with other artists, I've loved. The sound design stuff is cool, the album has a lot of, like, good flows and really heavy drops that are super cool. Mr. Bill just killed it with this album, rocked my world. If I remember correctly, there are only two tracks that I skip, which are Real to Real and Bring It On. And some people may argue with me on this, but you don't even need these songs to enjoy the album. Like, the album is absolutely phenomenal. My bass is so impeccable. We've got ourselves Chompo 2, which is the second compilation from Tokyo Machine's record label that he started last year, called Chompo. I will say, I think that Chompo 1 is better and has a lot more of a classic feel and will probably go down in the history of Chompo, obviously as the debut, but once Chompo has been going on for several years, Chompo 1 is gonna have that nostalgia factor, but Chompo 2 is still very solid compilation album, and it takes a little bit of a darker direction from Chompo 1, but it's just cool to see because you can get more artists in that way. I will say there are some that I skip from that as well, which I'm disappointed about just because of the artists involved. The Panda Eyes track, the MDK track, and the Teddy Lloyd track, I think are the only ones that I skip, but other than that, album's very solid, and it got me on a Chompo kick for a little while, but I think every Chompo compilation album is gonna get me on a Chompo kick. I think that's just the beauty of the record label. Kind of back and forth last month on whether or not we enjoyed my more chill tracks or my more energetic tracks. We were kind of split on that, but I showed you a really chill track last month, so I figured that I would show you something more energetic that I've been working on. I just want to say, This is just a preview, and it sounds a little messy just because I added something in to give it more presence pretty recently and didn't have an opportunity to like mix it in well so that it sat well in the mix. But this one's a real interesting one. Way out there from what I normally make. It's at 200 beats per minute or 100 beats per minute in double time for much of the track, and it's on the Phrygian scale, so there's just all sorts of little crazy things about it. Something that I haven't quite been working on, but I've been throwing the idea around of perhaps a third songwriting driven EP, maybe some sort of spiritual successor slash trilogy closer for Obscure Sorrows and A Letter to Myself. I normally feel this whenever I have a larger amount of songs that I'm working on all at the same time that may, you know, be able to be finished by the same time so that I can release them all at once. I guess that's maybe the discussion question. Are you guys interested in seeing a whole EP that's kind of a spiritual successor to A Letter to Myself earlier in the year, or would you like me to get the singles out one by one? That actually leads into the discussion question I was planning on doing all along, which is just this whole idea of releasing singles before an EP. I've gotten, or before an album, because I've gotten kind of mixed opinions on this, on whether people should just release the entire album all at once, or if they should release one or two singles before the album. A lot of people, especially in this music space over the past maybe 4 or 5 years, have been releasing almost the entire album in singles, and then only having a couple of songs that are unique that you haven't heard before to listen to when the album comes out. The rule that I normally go by is the 40% rule, which is I release about 40% of the album rounded down before the album comes out. I release that as singles. And then I release the rest of the album as an album. It gets a little muddy with bonus tracks, because if you were a Chill Pill fan before I became Nomadder, then you'll actually recognize several of the bonus tracks because they came out as Chill Pill tracks. But you know, everybody does it differently. So if you release music, what rule do you go by? Does it depend on the project? And if you're just a listener and you don't release music, or you don't release music yet, how many singles do you like to have before the album or EP comes out? Let me know in the comments. That's our discussion question for this month. Okay, so one thing that I've been learning, it's getting to the end of April and school ends for me sometime in early May. I've been working on trying to set my priorities in each moment and not just my priorities in terms of values, or what I consider to be productive on the whole, because sometimes there are several things that are productive that may not be helpful for me to do in the moment. So I gotta do the things that are important right now and do those other things later. But you know, what are those things? That's where the work-life balance comes in. And it used to be that I put so much time into work that I didn't leave myself any time to rest. And so I had to teach myself to factor rest into my schedule. But then I kind of got used to that, and I started to rest more and more, or do activities that I thought would be restful. Sometimes they aren't, like doom scrolling is not restful. Sitting there just watching a bunch of YouTube videos, thinking about how I could be doing other productive things, that's not restful either. At this point, instead of what it used to be, which is trying to factor more rest into my work, I'm trying to factor more work, not into my rest, I guess, but more work in between my times of rest, because if I rest too much at the expense of work, then that can turn into laziness. So I'm just trying to build those priorities, or I guess, reestablish those priorities. There are some practical ways that I can do that. A lot of times in terms of work, it's all up to if I start my work, I'm probably gonna end up finishing it, or I'm probably gonna end up doing some wonderful progress on it. I just have to start it. I have to take that step. And for rest, I've got to do things that are actually restful. And in some sense, things that are productive within my rest, you know, like spending time with the Lord or doing music. That's one way, that's one activity that truly gives me rest and fulfillment. And sometimes it's just little things, you know, it's writing a journal entry, it's going outside and taking a walk. That's what I've been learning, resetting my priorities. So that's my April. I hope that your April has been going well. There's a lot of good music to listen to out there, and I hope that you guys are checking it out and listening to it. Speaking of which, as of the day that I'm recording this, my friend Matthew Parker is actually coming out with a new album. So if you're interested, definitely go check that out. It's called Fly Me to the Moon and Leave Me There. And of course, as each monthly update comes out, I'll make you aware of the things that I'm listening to so that you can go check out all of these people and all of these projects as well. So until then, I'll see you guys later. No Matter out.